In this gritty and exceptionally honest rendering of wartime and the traumas of coming home, the author educates us about the importance of listening to the cries of soldiers and being diligent to their emotional needs. If we don't listen, we run the risk of tragedy even greater than war. So, one thing I like about this book is that, it takes place in Baghdad and the Dyersville, and even if they don't go to busy. I'm a wife, mother, daughter, sister, friend, neighbor, writer, and I know all too well that settling feeling. But over the course of the last few years, I've learned a new way to live, marked by grace, love, rest, and play, and it's changing everything. Present over perfect is an invitation to this journey that has changed my life. I'll walk this path with you, a path away from frantic pushing and proving, and toward your essential self, the one you were created to be before you began proving and earning for your worth. So, I went through and I underlined some stuff in there that I thought, kind of that I felt was like really important. So, one thing I highlighted was how we live matters and what you choose to own will shape your life, whether you choose to admit it or not. The most important things aren't things. I'm able to give more focused attention on the higher stakes decisions in my life when I don't think hard about what to wear or how to manage all my stuff. What makes you say, must be nice? What longing might your jealousy be leading to, if you're brave enough to listen to it before you push away? Sometimes being brave is being quiet. Sometimes brave looks boring, and that's totally, absolutely okay. So, I would definitely recommend this book to anyone that likes reading kind of self-help books, books that kind of point out things that maybe you hadn't thought about before. I will give a warning though. I myself am not the biggest fan of religious reads. This, while there are like a good chunk of the chapters that kind of, I mean, they don't deal with religion, a lot of her stuff does also deal with God. So that's just a forewarning. I know sometimes it can be harder for people. It was definitely harder for me to read those chapters that were all about God. So, again, this is called Present Over Perfect. So, I got it at Target. This down here says it was $24.99. I really doubt that I paid that much because I don't like paying a whole lot for books. Still find it at Target. Otherwise, if you have a bookstore, I would definitely check there, obviously, because they're books. but, like, we have a bookstore here called BAM, Books A Million. So you can either check out, like, the popular ones. Otherwise, if you like shopping local, I'm sure they have either this book or something similar to it. And then, I know some people, like, they really base, if they're gonna read a book, off whether, like, how long it is. So this is 234 pages. I will say, I got through this one. It probably took me like 2 weeks to read it, just because it was so, like, I couldn't get over it. Like, it was kind of hard to read some of the chapters about God, because I don't believe the same thing as her, so it was kind of hard to get through that. But again, you can skim through it, and some of the sentences, like, they really stick out to you if they mean a lot to you. So this is another one. This is called The Gifts of Imperfection. Let go of who you think you're supposed to be and embrace who you are. This is by Brené Brown. This is a soft cover. Oh, there's a bookmark in there. So, let's see. I got this book off thriftbooks.com. I definitely recommend Thrift Books. I'll leave a link in the description. But you can get books like this one. Let's see. This was originally $15 and I got it for $2. So you can get books for really, really cheap. But obviously they're used, so you kind of get what you pay for in a way. I have some other books that I've gotten off Thrift Books and they came in great shape. But this one did have some writing in it, and it looks like a receipt. So, the person who landed writing on it, so it doesn't look like it's throughout the whole book, so maybe if I can get, oh wait, maybe it is. Maybe if I can get past that, I'll be able to read this, but, and then it's groundbreaking New York Times bestseller. So it was just another ordinary day at McKinley High until a massive explosion devastated the school. When loner David Thorpe tried to help his English teacher to safety, the teacher convulsed and died right in front of him, and that was just the beginning. A year later, McKinley has descended into chaos. All the students are infected with a virus that makes them deadly to school. In this frighteningly dark and captivating novel, Lex Thomas locks readers inside a school where kids don't fight to be popular, they fight to stay alive. So, this one. Let's see. This one is 404 pages. And 41 chapters long. And like, something cool about this book is Lex Thomas is actually
bless you.
I paid $10.99 for it. So it's also called a modern day Lord of the Flies. So again, if you like sci-fi, kind of apocalyptic fiction, obviously, you can definitely pick this one up.
Okay, buddy.
The next book I have is one that I'm still reading. I think I'm too far into it. And honestly, it's been a while since I've read it, so I'll probably have to start over. Because I'm only on page 75, so. But this is Quarantine the Saints. So there's Quarantine the Loners and then Quarantine the Saints. So it takes place from different cliques' perspectives. Kind of bounces around from characters. So again, this is the second of this one. This says McKinley High has been a battleground for 18 months since a virus outbreak led to a military quarantine of the school. When the doors finally open, Will and Lucy think their nightmare is finished, but they are gravely mistaken. As a new group of teens enters the school and gains popularity, Will and Lucy join the new gangs. An epic party on the quad full of real food and drinks where kids hook up and actually interact with members of other games. Gangs seems to signal a new, easier existence. Soon after, though, the world inside McKinley takes a startling turn for the worst, and Will and Lucy will have to fight harder than ever to survive. And deadly halls of McKinley High in the Quarantine series. And then this one. So this actually gives a little preview of the third book, which is Quarantine the Burnouts. But it looks like this one has a 42 chapters. It's 384 pages long. And then it seems this was published in 2013. So I don't know how this one's going so far because, again, it's been so long since I started it that I probably have to start over. Spy. close reading and they don't like it. So if you don't like pictures, this one might be a little harder to read. But this book is this is 382 pages. And it was published originally published in 2011, and then the first paperback edition was in 2013. So if you like, I don't know how to like describe it. If you like history but you also like the future, and you like, they're not superpowers, but they're oh my gosh, I don't know, it's so hard to explain. If you don't want to watch it, I know there is a movie, so you just basically, the other books kind of set this book up a little bit. This boy goes to a school that is meant to fix him because he is gay. And it's actually taking place in an asylum, so there's some creepy stuff going on, so he's got to figure out what's going on. And then this is just like what happened in the asylum to make the other people that go to school there later on after it's been down. This is like what happened in the asylum to make things a little creepier, but this, let's see, so at the end it always gives a prequel to something. It's 343 pages. I got this at the bookstore again for $10, and then this is the first in the series. I got this one for $5.88. So you kind of been living under a rock since 1997, you either have seen the movies, read the books, or you at least know about Harry Potter. But I love these books. I think I've read them like 5 times, which really like isn't a lot when you think about it. But the very first one in this series is called Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. So, the fifth one is honestly just so interesting because I was like, oh, I've never thought about some of this stuff before. I got this on Sam's Club for $10.90. I read it in like a day, but yeah, it's actually super interesting. I would definitely recommend reading this, even if you don't really care about surviving a zombie apocalypse. It's just like the facts that they give and like the science behind like whether or not things are actually going to happen is just really interesting. I've had this book for a really, really long time. This is What Do You Want to Do Before You Die by The Buried Life. So it's a group of two brothers, four friends that go around crossing things off their bucket list. I actually keep a small copy of my bucket list in here. So they have their own bucket list ideas, but then they also have ideas from other people, like what they want to do in their life. I like this book because it gives you an idea of like more stuff that you want to do before you die, but then like reading through it, it kind of gives you the idea like life could end and we might not expect it. So, you know, I hate to bring this up, but Kobe Bryant died in a helicopter crash, and I'm sure he just carried on with his day like nothing, like he didn't know he was going to pass away. And his daughter died, and then the teammate and the two parents, the pilot, you know, there's a lot of people in it. It was a fatal crash. But they all, like, they didn't know it was their last day. So